Ladies and gentlemen, hello and welcome to Leicester Square. How are you doing? It is a very good evening to be in Leicester Square, and it allows me to welcome you to this, the UK premiere of the Wolverine! So, prepare to get very excited, because very shortly we are going to be welcoming the stars of the movie down on this red carpet, which includes the gorgeous Famke Janssen, the two Japanese leading ladies, Tao Okamoto and Rila Fukushima, American action man Will Yun Lee, and the director of The Wolverine, the man who has brought this movie to the big screen, James Mangold, will be here. But that's not all. Of course, it wouldn't be a premiere for The Wolverine without The Wolverine himself. Star of the film, Hugh Jackman, will be joining us here in London's Leicester Square. Now, you lot need to be smart and brush your hair, because, as well as all of that, we are going live via the World Round Web across the globe, every corner of the planet. People will be tuning in to watch this premiere live from 6 o'clock. So, Leicester Square, we need to let them know what a good time we're having here. A cheer on the count of three. One, two, three! That was amazing. That was amazing. Okay, so they'll be watching at thewolverinemovie.com and also facebook.com/thewolverinemovie. But your responsibilities don't end there. We want to hear from you. Questions for Hugh, comments about the premiere, get on Twitter. It's #TheWolverineLive. That's #TheWolverineLive. Now be prepared to make a lot of noise, because very soon the UK premiere for The Wolverine begins. This is a face you won't forget in a hurry. She stars as Yukio in The Wolverine. It's the striking Rila Fukushima!
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the UK premiere of the Wolverine! A big thank you to all of you who have joined us here in Leicester Square, and a massive hello if you have joined us online at thewolverinemovie.com. So, it is a very exciting time here in Leicester Square because we are going to be joined very shortly by the stars of this amazing new movie, which include the gorgeous Famke Janssen. We also have the two leading Japanese ladies in the movie, Tao Okamoto and Rila Fukumishima. They're here as well. We also have Will Yun Lee, the American action hero, coming down, as well as the man who has put this movie on the big screen. Director James Mangold will be here, and he's sure to be telling us all about what it was like to work with who is rumored to be the nicest man in Hollywood, the Wolverine himself, the legend, who is Hugh Jackman! Yes, your right to cheer. That is all on the way. Now, if you want to watch live online or pass this information on to your friends, it is Wolverine. It is the it is Facebook. Oh, I get that right. It's facebook.com/ The Wolverine Movie. And of course, we want to hear from you. So get on Twitter as soon as possible. Let's hear from people in the square. You can send in your questions for any of the cast. It is hashtag The Wolverine Live. That's hashtag The Wolverine Live for your questions and comments on Twitter. So, with all that in mind, it seems like the right time to remind ourselves why we are all here. Take a look at the trailer for The Wolverine. Please welcome to the UK premiere red carpet in her first acting role, the stunning Tao Okamoto! Tao Okamoto co-stars as the heiress Mariko in The Wolverine. Tao is a Japanese native born in the Chiba Prefecture. Tao Okamoto co-stars as the heiress Mariko in The Wolverine. Tao is a Japanese native, born in the Chiba Prefecture area on the eastern side of Japan. She made her modeling debut at 14 years old and, not surprisingly, hasn't stopped working for the last 14 years. In November 2010, Tao was awarded the Vogue Nippon Woman of the Year and is currently one of Japan's top models on the international stage. The Wolverine is Okamoto's first feature film, and we're delighted to have her here on our red carpet in London. peoples of Leicester Square. This is the moment we've been waiting for, arriving in an Audi Spider. He is the reason we are all here today. Please make a considerable amount of noise to welcome to the UK premiere of the Wolverine, Mr. Hugh Jackman!
Top.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm joined now by one of the gorgeous leading ladies in the Wolverine. It's Rila Fukushima! First of all, I'd love to know what you make of the reaction here in London.
Yeah, it's exciting. I didn't expect it to see everyone here like this, so I'm very excited, but I'm a little bit nervous.
You shouldn't be nervous. You're fantastic in this movie. Tell us a little bit about Yukio, the character you play.
I play the character of Yukio. She works for powerful Yoshida family in Wolverine and highly trained in martial arts. She's a badass. So, yeah, it's like the film starts like she trying to find Logan, bringing him back to Japan. That's the first mission of Yukio.
I really like her sword work. She has a magnificent sword in the movie. Is that one of the new skills you had to learn for this film? Because you are awesome with it.
Oh, thank you very much. I had 3 weeks training before we start filming, but I never done any action stunt. So I had 3 weeks, but I only have 3 weeks. So.
Only 3 weeks? Because you're magnificent with it. That's fantastic. And how was it working with Hugh Jackman as the Wolverine?
If I start talking about Hugh, I can go on forever. It's going to take for like a whole day. But working with Hugh, he's very patient. And he's a great actor at the same time. He's very, very nice. And he gave me a lot of advice because this is first film for me, so it was amazing experience to work with Hugh. I got a lot of inspired from him because about after working with him, I want to keep continue acting.
That's good. I imagine he's a very inspirational man, Hugh Jackman. We have some great questions that have been tweeted to us online. This first one is from Frederick J. And he says, what is Yukio's mutant power?
Oh, well, you guys should watch the film. You should watch the film.
Okay, good. Frederick J., it's a secret so far. You're going to have to go to the cinema and watch The Wolverine. And June P. says, whereabouts in Japan did you film The Wolverine?
I think we mostly shot in Australia, and then we shot in Tokyo, and also we shot in Tomonora in Hiroshima Prefecture, which is countryside, beautiful. I really love to be there. I had never been there before, so.
That's fantastic. Well, listen, rather than keep you chatting up here, I'm going to let you go and enjoy your premiere. Ladies and gentlemen, the gorgeous and brilliant Rila Fukushima! Onto your warrior swords, ladies and gents, and make some noise for our big screen ninja, Mr. Will Yun Lee!
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Will-Yun Lee! First of all, we're looking at this camera right here. Hey, how was that walk down the red carpet? How have you found the fans here at the premiere in London?
It's amazing. It's amazing. I was here many years ago, and I don't remember it like this, so it's beautiful.
It's pretty special. Everyone's so excited about this movie.
I haven't seen it either, so I'm excited.
You're seeing it for the first time tonight?
Yeah.
I bet you can't wait.
I can't wait.
Let me tell you, you're awesome in it. Tell us a little bit about the character you play.
I play a character named Harada, and it's kind of a mysterious character, and you kind of have to watch the course of the movie and kind of see which line he falls on. There's a little bit of going after the Wolverine, and we'll see what happens at the end.
Because you have a very, very physical role in the movie. Just how much training did you have to do to prepare for this role?
I spent about a month with the guys, and but it's, you're only as good as as the other actor that you're doing action with, and Hugh's timing is impeccable, and he's always he always scares me, so it was good.
What was the toughest challenge, though? Because was it learning the skill of archery, because you're very good with a bow, or was it just the action in general?
Working with someone like Hugh, he's always makes it really comfortable for you on set, and I think that's usually the hardest part, is kind of finding that chemistry even in a fight. So that was probably he made it easy.
Yeah, the fights are great. They're like really painful ballets.
It is. I mean, I remember shooting a scene in Japan, and we were on top of the rooftops, and that was probably the scariest thing. Higher than that, and just running along the edges, trying to shoot a bow and look cool at the same time.
Wait, that was done for real?
Yeah.
Wow, okay, good work. We've had some questions come in online for you, Will. Let's start with this one from Victor M. He says, tell us about the stunts. What action sequence are you most excited for fans to see?
I've seen pieces of the movie, and I think the one that I'm excited the most is the Thousand Ninja versus Wolverine fight.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so that should be pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, I feel weird because I've seen it. That is pretty cool.
I've seen it. Okay, cool.
Holly K says, how would you describe the fighting style used in the film, and what were its influences?
I think the biggest style is the Japanese style fighting, so everything was deep traditional stances, and I come from a different background, so that was probably a difficult part of the training, is to make sure that the swords were right and the stances were right, but you got to still look cool doing it.
And finally, from Richard S. Now, obviously, we heard a lot about Hugh Jackman now training for the movie, but Richard S. says, what kind of fitness regime did you have to endure to prepare for this role?
What did I have to do? I think I was just in awe of watching Hugh work out. So I worked out with the 8711 guys, and we did it every day. And I went home sore every day. And here we are.
Awesome stuff, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it for the fantastic Will-Yun Lee.
Have you been in the pub all this time?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the producer of the Wolverine, Hutch Parker. Hello, sir. How are you? How are you finding this premiere?
It's fantastic. I mean, it doesn't get much better than this, I don't think.
It's all right. A nice weather for once, which is good. Now, you've been involved with the X-Men series for a long time. Tell us about how you've been involved with the X-Men films.
Primarily as an executive. I was at Fox for almost 20 years, and so kind of have been involved with all the different iterations of the franchise. But most recently now as a producer.
And in terms of the series, because it's really endured, I mean, look at the turnout here to support this movie. What do you think it is about the X-Men films that have made them so loved by audiences?
I think it's that they're characters that you can care about, that you really relate to, and hopefully we also give them a pretty great ride when the time comes to have an action sequence or take them on a ride. It's pretty spectacular. You'll see that tonight if you haven't seen the film yet. It's pretty amazing in terms of what Jim Mangold and Hugh deliver. So I think that's really the cornerstone of it.
Well, let's talk about the Wolverine. Is this the quintessential Wolverine story?
It really is. I mean, it's a character we love because he's conflicted, because he's dark and tortured. And by far, this is the most challenging journey he's ever been on. It takes him down to arguably the lowest we've ever seen him, and watches him fight back against villains the likes of which we really haven't put against the Wolverine before in a way that's unique. I think the villain in particular is one that both cinematically and in terms of the way he challenges Logan is kind of for all time.
And obviously, a very unique setting for a superhero movie in any language. We're in Japan. What was it that made you want to take this story to Japan?
Well, this is really based on an iconic comic book itself, one that has much been beloved and that Hugh personally and James Mangold, our director, felt strongly needed to come to the screen. And that forced us into a very unique environment and one that I think, because it's so alien to us, it's like going to another world. And we get to experience it and see it through his experiences, but also in ways that I've never been to Japan. I've never seen this culture this way. So it's special as a filmmaking experience to be able to go somewhere you haven't been and create something unique for the audience.
And in terms of Hugh Jackman himself, obviously you're working with him again on X-Men Days of Future Past. You work with him on this movie. What's that like?
It sounds ridiculous. It sounds like we're, but it doesn't get any better. He's literally the best I've ever worked with in any position. He's as dedicated, as professional, as decent, as caring. As talented as anybody you could hope to work with. He makes everybody else look bad, to be honest.
All right, we have some questions that have been sent in from our viewers who are watching around the globe. You're also producing X-Men Days of Future Past. I'm looking forward to that. But are there any action scenes in particular in this movie we should look forward to? And that's from Helen I.
Helen, you got to watch for the bullet train. The bullet train is a unique experience in life. It's a particularly unique experience in this film.
It is awesome. Hey, Hugh, it's lovely seeing you here. Have a great premiere.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hugh Parker! Now, if you want to comment on tonight's event or you want to ask Hugh Jackman or any of the cast a question, best hurry to our Facebook and Twitter pages. We've already had loads of messages in. Thank you to @defendpopcorn, who said, I actually can't wait for the Wolverine movie to come out. @SamTracy says, the Wolverine is going to be amazing. #... Can't wait. And Shyam Patel says, this movie looks awesome. I so want to watch it. And finally, Ikra Iqbal says, epic! Exclamation mark. I already have goosebumps! Exclamation mark. Once again, it is #TheWolverineLive on Twitter or on Facebook. It's facebook.com/TheWolverineMovie. Head there for comments and questions. Ladies and gentlemen, playing Mariko in the movie, please welcome Tao Okamoto to the stage. Hello, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
You look wonderful. How have you found the premiere so far?
I feel so good. Thank you so much.
Oh, good. Right, let's start with Mariko, first of all. Tell us a little bit about the character and how she fits into the story.
Yes, so I play this girl, Mariko. She's from the wealthier family in Japan, and I think she's always... very isolated, very outcast from the social, and that was something she could share with Wolverine because she's a mutant. She's, you know, he's holding the sorrow, sadness, and you know, I don't think it was difficult to fall into him for her.
Good stuff. Now, obviously, you come from a modeling background. How does acting in a movie, and not just a movie, but a movie of this scale, compare?
I never interested in acting before, but now I think I've been always acting. For like fashion shoot, fashion magazine shoot, or like campaign shoot, you know, I loved like transferring someone else on set. That's I'll always loved. And plus, now I can speak, I can use my voice and lots of actions, and it's just amazing.
Oh, fantastic. And how did it go in the audition process? Did you actually do a reading with Hugh Jackman himself?
Yes, I did three-time audition. First, video audition. Second, meeting with James Mangold in LA. And the third one, that was the last one, with Hugh. That was reading, but he wanted to do improvisation. And I didn't even know what was improvisation was. And then, for some reason, I got to kiss him at the end for, you know, by accident. It wasn't a script. It wasn't scripted. So I was like, oh my God, did I just kiss Hugh Jackman? Yeah.
I think for a lot of people here, that sounds like the best audition in the world. That must have been great. Okay, we've had some questions come in for your lovely self from people watching online. First of all, from James R., how authentic are the Japanese details in the film?
It's very, very great that we have this very modern part of Japan, but also very historical, traditional bits, and it's just great mixture. And yeah, of course, sometimes we found something not very Japanese, but like all the departments, like costume and set design, they very careful to listen to us. So every time like one of our Japanese guests finds something quite not Japanese, they just fix immediately. And I think this is the best movie focused on like a lot of elements like samurai, ninja, bullet train, yakuza. There's no movie like this.
Awesome. And one final question from the online community. Sharina S says, what is Logan's relationship like with Mariko?
Like I said, like they both sharing this, having this isolated life. They always like, you know, feel they don't belong there, so they've been looking for someone or somewhere they can belong to. But that for Mariko, Logan was the solution for her at that time, I think.
Amazing. Listen, I hope you really enjoy this UK premiere. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Tao Okamoto. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the gorgeous and very talented Famke Janssen. It is fantastic to see you here. Now, obviously, we know you from the previous X-Men films. How exciting is it being back involved in what is quintessentially an X-Men movie?
It's such an honor. I died twice. I didn't think they were, even though I am the Phoenix and I resurrect from the ashes, and that's, you know, rise from the ashes and resurrect, that's part of the character of the Phoenix. But it's still a surprise. It's been a franchise that has given the opportunity to so many different women and incredible female strong parts too. So the fact that they've brought me back in this one and in a, you know, a small cameo part, but an essential one in terms of the through line of the story, and got to work with Hugh Jackman again, who's amazing, of course, and James Mangold, who did an incredible job. So I'm nothing but grateful.
Yeah, you do play a very integral role in the story, though. There's a lot of emotion there. We're not giving too much away, of course. So obviously, in previous...
Snogging.
There is, yeah, some snogging. In previous films, Logan and Jean's relationship has been somewhat flirtatious. How would you describe their relationship, and how has it evolved in this film?
Well, it goes on a deeper and a different level. And I really don't want to give too much away. I think the film is a surprise on many levels. It's gorgeous to look at. The setting of Japan is incredible. There's some new female characters that are truly spectacular. And it has depth as well as action. So it really is really for a much broader audience, I think, than any of the ones that I've seen so far. So I'm really, really happy for people to see this one.
And you touched on it already, because, I mean, like you, I find Hugh Jackman amazing. What was it like working with him again?
Amazing. he's truly, he's so gifted as an actor. He's so giving as a person. He's given this franchise so much weight. And he's been kind throughout the entire process, so...
He sounds even more awesome. Perfect, good. Yes. So we've got some questions from the online community who have said this. Phoebe R. says, what has been your most memorable X-Men fan-based experience? Any fans, anything tonight?
Well, it has a little bit of competition with the Bond fan base. Because, of course, you know, in there I can squeeze men between my thighs, so that gets a lot of attention. But, you know, it's been, they've been good experiences, not really creepy ones like the Bond ones.
Yeah, I can imagine. Were you excited, and this is from Patrick S.,
I do actually want to say my name is Famke, not Jean, just so people know that.
Okay.
Ask me next time.
Absolutely, good. Famke.
Famke.
Were you excited, Famke, this is from Patrick S., to revisit Logan and Jean's relationship on screen? You've kind of answered that, but it must have been exciting.
It's been very exciting because we ended on such a high note at X-Men The Last Stand at the end of it with the killing of Wolverine, you know, Logan killing the Jean Grey / Phoenix character, that I think a lot of people felt kind of robbed of the emotions they wanted to feel at that moment and sort of having some payoff, and that we have now.
Awesome stuff. Listen, I hope you have a really good premiere tonight. It's lovely to see you
so
again.
Much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Famke Janssen! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the man responsible for bringing the Wolverine to the big screen, director James Mangold! So let's start at the beginning. How was your walk down this carpet? What do you make of the turnout for this movie? People are so excited.
You know, Hugh Jackman in this role, in the role of Logan, Wolverine, is one of the great, you know, it's one of the great ongoing legendary performances in the last 100 years, along with, I think, Eastwood and Sean Connery. I think he's laying down a legacy playing this role. And it's no surprise that fans are turning out to see him because he's so brilliant in it.
And in terms of the movie, will people need to have been following the X-Men films to fully appreciate this movie, or is it more of a standalone adventure for the Wolverine?
It works both ways. I set out to make a movie that would very much work on its own. Just, you know, when you see Dirty Harry, you don't have a movie about how Dirty Harry became Dirty Harry. It just starts. We made a movie about Logan where he's just Logan, and here he is. And the challenges that come to him, you see right away, and you follow, and you learn. For those who, if it's someone's first Wolverine film, we provide as many clues as we can as you go along, and maybe your partner can fill it in.
Now, in terms of this particular story, why was it this story that both you and Hugh wanted to tell with this film?
Well, this particular story, based on a comic book saga by Frank Miller and Chris Claremont, was a really great opportunity. If we wanted to take the tone darker, which we did, and we wanted to get more intense with the Wolverine film, I think going to Japan gave us kind of an umbrella to just press reset on everything and hit a brand new tone. One that's been influenced by samurai films, westerns, predominantly the great tradition of Japanese filmmaking.
And I've heard that you really asked Hugh to go sort of angrier. I guess the best way of describing it is more berserk than he had ever been before in this film.
I don't think, I felt like I hadn't seen, I'd heard about the berserker rage when I was growing up reading the comics. I had read about the berserker rage, but I wanted to see the berserker rage. And that involves setting up some set pieces of action, I think, where you just see him slice and dice. And you see him go at it. There's no jumping up and grabbing helicopters and bring him down to the ground. This is a Logan with his feet on the ground, leveling mayhem with his claws.
Absolutely. Right, let's take some questions from online. People have been sending them in. This is Curtis A, who says, oh, and this is a key character in the film. If you had to describe the Silver Samurai in one word, what word would you choose? I'm going to give you three, because that might be impossible.
A mystery only the film will answer. I'm sorry, Curtis. To go there would be ruining the third act for you. I'm sorry.
Okay.
What you've seen in the trailer is as much as you're going to see in here until you see the film.
I think that's a wise answer. A wise answer. And finally, Sally R., we've kind of touched on this already. How is Logan different in this film from previous outings?
Well, Sally, there's another part of the question that I can answer that goes a little deeper, which is when we find Logan, this is after all the existing X-Men films. This is after the X-Men are gone, after Jean Grey is gone, after Professor X is long gone, and Jean Grey, by the way, at his own hand, dead. So we're finding a Logan in a very deep and dark place, living in the Yukon, hiding away from everyone. And the journey of the film is the one of him coming out from there and rejoining the world.
Brilliant. Mr. James Mangold, a pleasure seeing you here. Enjoy the rest of your premiere. Ladies and gentlemen, James Mangold!
Thank you, Alex. Pleasure. Pleasure.
Related to the X-Men wouldn't be an X-Men movie if it wasn't for mutants. And one particularly villainous mutant in this film that you should keep an eye out on is Viper. Take a look at this.
You.
Me.
What are you?
A chemist. Nihilist. Capitalist. A mutation. A viper.
There is a weird sort of connection between Logan and Viper, even though they are enemies.
His flesh is weak now.
Not healing it before.
I did that.
He knows she's pulling the strings to some extent, but he doesn't realize how far or how much.
I'm joined now on the stage by Hiro Sanada. Hello, sir. How are you?
Very fine, thank you. It's so exciting.
It's fantastic to have you here in London for the premiere. Let's talk first about your character, Shingen, and how he fits into the story of the Wolverine.
Yeah, Shingen was in the original comics, but completely different role in the movie. So even a big fan of comics, they can be surprised in the movie.
Now, I'm right in thinking you've trained in martial arts from a very young age. How useful was that in this film? Because you do have a fair share of action sequences.
Yeah. Actually, I was a child actor since I was 5 years old. But I saw a lot of European and American movies. And then I decided to train in all the martial arts and everything. And then I've done a lot of samurai movie and action movie in Japan. So it was very natural thing for me for using the sword. But this time it was hard to find out the best distance between Hugh, because he has a famous claws, yep, like this long, and then I had a two swords in my hand, but his claw is short, but his reach is twice as much as mine, and his one step is my three steps, so it's very hard to find out the best distance, but he's a great fighter, so the shooting was so smooth, and totally no accident, no injured for him, so I'm so happy about that.
And for you too, I hope.
Oh, yes.
Good.
Yeah, survived.
And now, obviously, you just mentioned some other movies. I've seen you in the fantastic film, The Last Samurai. How is it joining a movie like this, which, as you can see, has such a huge following already?
Yeah, I'm feeling the power of the big franchise series movie, and especially with Hugh. Yeah, so exciting. This is the first time to watching the movie with the audiences. So, I'm so happy to be here.
Fantastic. Well, we're very happy you're here. Ladies and gentlemen, Hiro Sanada.
Thank you.
Okay, just rush in the middle, please. To the middle now, look straight ahead. this. It's like bachelor
party. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the star of the Wolverine, Mr. Hugh Jackman! That's fantastic. Hugh, what do you make of this reception here in London?
I'm amazed. Thank you. I saw people who were here at 6 o'clock this morning, people from all around the world. It means the world to me. Thank you so much for coming out.
It's so great to have you here, and for this character and this movie. So at 6 times playing the Wolverine, soon to be 7, a record for any actor playing a superhero. What do you love about playing this character so much?
I may be biased, but I think he's just the coolest, the funnest, most interesting of all of them. And I think after 4 or 5 more, I just might get it right, hopefully. But I'm absolutely loving it more than ever. And that's the truth of it.
Fantastic stuff. We're facing down this camera, Hugh, so everyone right at the back of this square can see us. Now, this is a very unique story in terms of, I've never seen a story like this that is a superhero movie. Why did you want to bring this version and vision of the Wolverine to this big screen?
When I was shooting X-Men 1, we were not allowed to read comic books, right? So the director said no one, and someone slipped, it was like contraband, someone slipped this particular comic book, the Japanese story, the samurai story, under my trailer door, and I read it. And I immediately went to Lauren Chiladonna, the producer. I said, this is going to be a movie. That was 13 years ago. And I kind of can't believe that we're here. We've done it. I think it's intriguing. It's one of the best stories from the comic book series. And to bring it to life, I think this movie feels fresh, different from any of the other X-Men or Wolverine movies. It won't matter if you haven't seen one before. This, to me, is the definitive Wolverine. This is the Wolverine.
And listen, the people are so excited for this movie. Tell me about the training, though.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Would you like to say hello?
Hello, everyone up there. How are you guys doing? What is that? Is that like an apartment?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, tell us, one thing I'm not sure you will have enjoyed quite as much as bringing this movie to the screen is the training element. How was it? Because genuinely, you are the most ripped, and I mean that as a compliment, the most ripped I've ever seen you playing this character in this film.
No, I was in the best shape. I actually went to Dwayne Johnson and I rang him and I said, mate, The Rock. I said, buddy, I need some tips. How do I, I lost some weight on Les Mis and I need to really sort of bulk up, get in shape. And he said, here's the deal, 3 hours a day in the gym, 6,000 calories, eating really lean, and you've got to do that for a minimum 6 months. So I signed up and I did it. Let me tell you, The Rock is crazy. That is insane. But we did it, the results there, and let me just say I won't be eating chicken breast tonight.
Now, obviously, you're working on X-Men Days of Future Past as the character, the Wolverine as well. And you've taken a break from filming to be here, but we actually have a special message from the set of X-Men Days of Future Past for you to have a watch now.
Hey, Hugh, it's your buddy here, Brian Singer. On the set of X-Men Days of Future Past here in Montreal. We're missing you terribly. You've got your claws, you've got your chicken breast. But seriously, have a great premiere. Have a really great time, and we'll see you soon. And to the fans out there, I've seen the movie, and I think this is the Wolverine film you've all been waiting for. Enjoy.
That's nice, isn't it?
That is nice, and that's exactly how I wrote it. So he really did a great job. No, that's we are having a blast. I got to tell you, 13 years ago, Brian gave me this role. It's a role that changed my life. I'm forever grateful to him. I'm forever grateful to the fans. I love playing Wolverine. We're having such a good time on Days of Future Past. I'm telling you, the fans are going to love it.
Awesome stuff. Well, we do have some fan questions for you right now. This is quite a good one from EmilyJ819. And I know you love the Wolverine. You are the Wolverine. Which other X-Men character would you have wanted to play if not the Wolverine, and why?
Well, that's a really good question. I actually kind of think Magneto.
A lot of love for that.
Yeah, no, Magneto's kind of pretty badass too. All actors kind of like to play the bad guy or semi-bad guy. So I reckon that's probably the part I'd like.
Awesome stuff.
And plus, he gets a muscle suit. He doesn't have to go to the gym.
Hugh, a pleasure to see you. Have you got a message for all the fans here in Leicester Square and watching across the world?
Well, to all the fans, I know it looks strange. I'm not looking at you, but I am looking at you. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. These last 13 years playing this character is something I will never forget. I'll treasure all my life. And the reason I'm doing it for so long is you guys. So thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, the brilliant Mr. Hugh Jackman! Now to celebrate one of the summer's biggest blockbuster releases, The Wolverine, those very clever people at Fox Film have created a unique interactive experience called Be the Wolverine that lets users take part in an out-of-home adventure. Take a look at this. Having completed that experience, fans will have the opportunity to share photos of them taking part via Facebook. So look out for that. So look out for that. It's making its way around the world and indeed will be at San Diego's Comic-Con, where Hugh Jackman and James Mangold are putting in an appearance.
Come on, Abby.
Golden Globe and Tony Award-winning performer Hugh Jackman has wowed audiences of all ages, proving that he is as successful on stage in front of live crowds as he is on a film set. From award-winning turns on Broadway to his metal claw-wielding Wolverine in the lucrative X-Men franchise, Jackman has proven to be one of the most versatile actors of our time. The Australian native made his first major US film appearance as Wolverine in the first installment of the X-Men series back in 2000, a role he reprised in the enormously successful X2 and X-Men The Last Stand in 2006. Most recently in the franchise, he played Wolverine in X-Men's Origins Wolverine, which serves as a prequel to the popular series, and grossed an outstanding $85 million in the US in its first weekend of release in 2009. None too shabby. Earlier this year, Jackman starred in the much-anticipated film adaptation of Les Miserables, directed by Tom Hooper, co-starring Anne Hathaway and Russell Crowe, based on the popular stage show originally created from Victor Hugo's famous novel of the same name. Jackman's standout performance as protagonist Jean Valjean earned him a Golden Globe Award for Best Actor in a Comedy or Musical, as well as a Screen Actors Guild nomination as Best Male Actor in a Leading Role. The film also garnered him his first Oscar nomination for Best Actor. Additionally, Jackman has starred in Sean Levy's Real Steel, Baz Luhrmann's Australia, Darren Aronofsky's The Fountain, Christopher Nolan's The Prestige, and Woody Allen's Scoop. In addition, he lent his voice to the animated features Happy Feet and Flushed Away. Other films in which he has leading roles include Deception, Someone Like You, Swordfish, Van Helsing, and Kate and Leopold, for which he received a 2002 Golden Globe nomination. But it's probably this character, the Wolverine, that Hugh is best known and loved for. And having taken on the role a staggering 6 times, with a 7th in the pipeline, he holds the record for the number of outings of a single character by one actor. From Wolverine to Jean Valjean and back to Wolverine again, there aren't many who could make this transition. Jackman has a versatility, and it must be said, an amiability that few stars possess. To be with us today, Hugh is taking a whistle-stop break from the Canadian set of the next X-Men movie, Days of Future Past, which, under the stewardship of original X-Men director Bryan Singer, reunites the team for a May 2014 release. It's already in the diary. Welcome to London, Hugh Jackman.
Wolverine is the ultimate outsider, and at the beginning of our movie, he's probably more isolated than you've ever seen Wolverine.
It's been an honor just to meet the Wolverine.
It's not who I am anymore.
The great battle I always thought with Wolverine is the battle within himself.
You have struggled long enough. I can end your eternity, make you mortal.
Monster, are you?
The Wolverine.
Well, now that Hugh Jackman and his co-stars are heading inside the Empire Cinema, all that's left for me to do is say a massive thank you to the crowd here in Leicester Square. They've been fantastic. And of course, to you watching online, and especially if you tweeted or got in contact via any social networking, we thank you for your questions and comments. But if you didn't get a question asked, there is another way. You could be doing it face to face. Yes, you can join a global live Skype chat with Hugh Jackman and James Mangold on Thursday at 4 p.m. British Summer Time on MSN. So that's 4 p.m. this Thursday. Hugh Jackman and James Mangold are going to be doing a live global Skype chat. The Wolverine in 3D hits cinemas everywhere very soon, but from here on the red carpet at the UK premiere, it's goodbye.